Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we are going to perform the optical measurement for an in-gun LED. So you need to make sure if you are using a gun, you need to set up the Horiba machine with 0.5, the slit, and in-gun is with 0.005. Now I will show you how to set up an LED inside the Horiba machine. After you have followed all these steps to set up the computer. So this is the how the Horiba machine inside looks like. So, okay, we need to connect the anode to brown wires and the cathode to the white colors. Okay, now after connecting the LED right here, so as you can see here, this thing right here is to adjust the position of the LED. I took either to move it closer to the screen right here, or you need to move it far away from it. So for example here, I put it in the middle, and then okay, and then okay, now you can test the, and then turn on the this power source, and it's, as you can see here, the LED is turning on. So right now I'm trying to make the LED as close as possible to the screen. Okay, and then you close the this lid and we go to our computer. Okay, now first of all you need to run the experiment first. This one, okay. Bonus, make sure that the side, the front exit entrance and also the side entrance is based on what material you are using. If we are using ingot, so the size is 0.005, as mentioned in the step by step to perform optical measurement. Okay, so now click monos and then you click on the click save and click run. Okay, so right now we are running the Horiba machine to measure from 200 nanometer wavelength to 800 nanometer wavelength. So let's wait for a while. Okay, it's almost finished. Write enter your name. Okay. Okay, for example, this is our result. Okay, double click and then you click on the collect right here, the analysis and picks. Alright, and then just click finish. Okay, this is to shows us what the picks is look like. So after we get this number, Now we can do the real time control. So to do real time control, first we need to click on collect and click on this real time control. So this is what it looks like inside. And then we need to change the position here to what the number that we have got just now, 552. Okay, change it to 552, and then you click enter. So your machine will move the position to 552, and then you click on the this thing, DPM or HV, right? Make sure that it is still 552, and then you click on the intensity. This is to show the CPS value. Okay, and then click on continuous and click run. Okay, this value is the light intensity for the closest range to the screen, as you can see from in the video that we have moved our LED as close as possible to the screen. Then after that, you need to jot down what's the value is. For example, right there is around 300 something. So 3 1 7 3 4 0 0. Okay, after that you move the LED. For example, further away from the screen. Like for example, in the middle. Okay, a little bit more. Okay, now we have the LED in the middle position. So you can see that the value of the CPS is going up. So next, jot down number 2, the middle. So we have around 3 4 6 2 1 0 0. Okay, so as you can see that the value is increasing. So why does the value is increasing? This is why. So as you can see here that just now we are test with the horror bar the full from 100 to from 200 to 800. So the graph will look like this. So if we move it closer to the, so we need to find the peak here. So maybe right now we are only at here, so we need to find maybe here or here, so we need to find it after we have moved it. So we need to move it the farther away. That's how you find how to adjust the real time value for the LED.